right this morning. Oh yeah.
We've got Vinnie here. We've got Vinnie.
What's going on, baby? What's going on?
We just came back from freaking Atlantic City, where I had the most triumphant return to the freaking tournament arena.
Glorious. Glorious.
Out of 68 people, I finished 14th. Not too shabby. Five more spots than I would have finished in the money, but what are you going to do? Not bad for my first outing back. So I was pretty pumped about that. It was awesome. I had a great time. And he was the guy that got me the food and got himself some drinking. He just kept himself busy in the casino. You too can come to New Jersey and hang out at the casino with Greg. Well, anyway, we're going to start with picks because the football game's going on right now. Obviously, he's an Atlanta man, so he's picked Atlanta, and I've picked Atlanta too. And so far, it's the third quarter, baby, and they're doing pretty fucking good. Anyway, for Houston and New England, I've got New England winning that game. How about you?
New England. Don't go against touchdown Tommy.
All right. And Green Bay versus Dallas.
That's a tough one right there. Ezekiel Elliott is my man. Go Bucks. But, man, it's going to be tough. Aaron Rodgers is on fire.
Aaron Rodgers.
Yeah.
Aaron Rodgers. I'm picking Green Bay.
Green Bay.
And then the last word is Pittsburgh, Kansas City.
Kansas ain't got enough offense.
I'm saying Kansas City has enough defense.
Hey, we'll see. That's why we play the game.
So that's how that goes down. Anyway, so call the bookies.
Yes.
And stay away from the Pittsburgh Kansas City
day. Don't listen to Cousin Sal. He's always wrong. I swear to God.
I got to call the bookies. pretty fine. That's why they call them pretty fucking four fingers. But anyway, I got some questions. I'm going to interview my boy here a little bit. Just a couple questions for him. I kind of preluded so we could think about his answers and see what he's got. Top five comic book characters. Marvel.
Well, I'm just picking my favorites. And I always liked Black Bolt. Before the Inhumans were popular, it wasn't because I'm black. I've always liked Nightcrawler. I've always liked Colossus. I've always liked Rachel Gray, like the Phoenix from Age of Apocalypse or Days of Future Past. Rachel.
Oh, okay.
Rachel, the daughter. Spidey, man. Like, Spidey, yo.
Spidey.
And I like those characters, man.
It's a good list. Top five DC comic characters.
Man, Rebirth changed a lot of things, but I like Swamp Thing. I know that sounds wild. I like Swamp Thing. I like Nightwing. Flash. Zatanna. I know it's weird. And Constantine, Vertigo. But yeah. I've always liked him.
All right.
He's an asshole. Right. I love it. He's cool.
On that, you've read a lot of the Rebirth series. Pretty much I've all caught up on all of them, right?
I'm pretty damn good.
What's
on
your
that?
Favorite run on that one?
Man, the Flash is going hard, man. Wonder Woman's second. Like, it's right there. And the Green Lantern. I mean... Man, that whole mythos is crazy, man.
I'm liking the Wonder Woman a lot. I'm not as caught up on the rest of them. Flash, I'm probably like 8 or 9 or something like that, somewhere in that neighborhood. But I like what I'm reading from that so far. But Wonder Woman and Flash is probably doing pretty good for me. Green Lantern's actually kind of gritty too. I like that one.
Cyborg's not bad either. Like, just don't sleep on Cyborg. Like, that's not a new
catch flag for that. Fuck Cyborg.
He's a Teen Titan, man.
Fuck Cyborg.
He's a Titan. He'll never be in the league.
Cyborg shit.
Man, dude. He's got infinite potential, man. Give up, man. Give it up for Cyborg, bro.
Yeah.
I'm leaving tomorrow, folks. I'm leaving tomorrow. This one.
He's catching an earlier fight because he doesn't like my opinion of Cyborg.
Yes. Yes. That is the reason.
But, all right. Favorite comic book movie of all time?
The Crow.
Nice. That's a good pick.
Yeah, it's
the
truth. It's the truth, man.
I probably would prefer... I don't even know what that might be. I love Blade because it was like kind of like that Marvel pioneer. But, Crow's a good pick. Crow's a good pick. But,
Soundtrack played a lot to do with The Crow, too, man. Like, that soundtrack is amazing.
Absolutely.
That is amazing.
The Crow soundtrack pretty much set the tone for soundtracks after.
It did.
So
it really did.
It kind of capitalized the whole soundtrack making business, actually.
You're absolutely
right. Every movie that came out after The Crow was kind of like, well, what are we going to put on the sound? They were thinking about that even before the fucking movie came out.
I mean, even with Guardians of the Galaxy, it's, you know, volume one, volume two.
That's kind of like a rebirth of really good music on a soundtrack.
Or putting good music in a movie, you know, not being cheap.
True.
You know, pay your royalties, people. Yes. Respect your artists and creatives, man.
Pay those artists.
Pay them, man.
It's good music. Went through all the trouble creating this shit for us.
We love it.
We do love it. Can DC right the ship as far as their cinematic universe is concerned? Or are they fucked? Yeah. Are they stuck in the mud?
No, they just have to, like, basically do like most businesses do. Just buy the talent. Just buy the talent. From Marvel.
Yeah.
Or get some new young star. Like, listen, young people are the future. I'm not trying to preach, but
I believe children
can fly. Yeah. Yeah. Fly. No, but seriously, like, you gotta, like, be progressive. Like, you can't have these people you gotta give the people what they want. That's in any business. So, like, it's already kind of been a model what Marvel's doing. You know what works. Just do what they do. Like, keep it light, keep it fun, keep it fresh.
Yeah.
They do it for the TV shows.
Yeah.
So why can't they translate that to cinema? It don't make no sense.
It doesn't make any sense. It's, I mean, Patty Jenkins is the one that's doing Wonder Woman, so it's kind of like hopefully that's going to be its own thing. But aside from that, it seems like Zack Snyder doesn't have his finger on the pulse, or he doesn't have enough control. It's one of those things. I know every single time I watch a DC film, I think there's too many paws, like snipping here and snipping there, or just trying to shape the movie after it's been fucking made, which is like the worst possible time to fucking make a movie. Because
then it's real choppy, it's not fluid. You can tell when it's not
fluid. The reshoots and blah, 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 you know. I mean, I hope they do, because in the interest of fucking making good quality fucking entertainment for all of us. What'd you think of Doc Strange?
I thought it was pretty dope.
Yeah?
I thought it was pretty dope. I like Doc Strange. I like the cartoon, the animated that came out some years ago. I watched that before he was popular and all that. But I always liked Doc
Strange.
One
of the few animated, you know, Marvel, as far as fucking animation is concerned, Marvel doesn't have a very rich history of doing the right thing by their characters.
Agreed. So, I mean, but see, that goes to the point, like, what's really the big difference between the disconnect of animation versus live action?
I don't know.
Like, a good story is a good story. So,
well, it's DC's like falling off a little bit, too, though.
I'd rather watch a DC animated movie than a Marvel animated movie twice on Sunday.
Well, because they're a little bit more organized with it, it seems like. It seems like they're more organized with that shit than they are with their fucking movies.
But this is funny. It's not like we're... Listen, it's simple. These people are professionals. Like, it's the business of making either animated films or live-action films. Like, I don't understand. Maybe it's a lot of red tape or egos or whatever, to your point you were saying earlier. It's behind the scenes. It's not the creatives.
Yeah.
It's just not. A good story is a good story.
Fine.
Like, really? I mean, it don't make no sense.
Trying to pull it off is trying to pull it off.
Yeah, I suppose so.
All right. What's your most anticipated comic book movie of 2017? Not including Star Wars shit.
Most anticipated... Honestly, it's Guardians of the Galaxy 2.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just want to see, like, because it was just fun.
Those guys were so awesome that you missed them. I miss those guys already. It's like they made characters that I fucking...
After they were clipped.
Yeah, good. You know, they made characters that you fucking care about. You know, like, so it's like, oh, I haven't seen those guys in a while. I'd love to fucking hang out for a couple hours with the fucking Guardians again, you know? So, yeah, I agree with that. Spider-Man's up there with me, too, but I don't know. I'm up in the air about
that. I'm ready to be disappointed for that, but I think it will be the best movie, but I'm ready to be disappointed. I'm just ready to be.
Skeptical dog is skeptical.
I'm skeptical. Yeah, I'm just saying, man, like, I think it's going to be good, but I'm ready to be disappointed. That's all, I mean, that's all. All right. That's all I got.
What do you think about the new whole, all of the Star Wars that's going on right now? Episode 8 or 7, F7 and freaking Rogue One. What do you think? Do you think that the Star, is it a rebirth or are they just a cash grab?
No, it's honestly a rebirth. And I think I watch a lot of YouTube videos and I'm a fan of like different theories and I read the comics. So I have like a different understanding of what they're doing and what they're trying to build as opposed to a casual fan who just wants to see, I want to see some more Skywalkers. It's like, well, shit, the universe is pretty goddamn big. Like, can we have more than just the Skywalkers? Can we develop? Can we grow into a universe? And I get a little passionate about that. But long story short, I think it's great. I love what they're doing. I love Rebels. Rebels is all day that stuff. Like, get on some Rebels. And always remember, like, with intelligent programming, there are no fillers. There are no fillers. There's always something that's going to play into something else. It's up to you as a viewer to go explore those other things that aren't spoon-fed to you.
Nah.
I'm done with that.
All right.
You know what I'm saying?
All right.
Falcons, baby. Falcons.
Story's going. Yeah, he's having a hard time paying attention. We're going to have to wrap this up soon because his Falcons are on. And
rise up, baby.
Let's see what's going on with that.
Natty Ice.
One more question, though. Yeah. Story scroll at the beginning of Rogue One. There wasn't one. Did you miss it? Did it take you out of the movie a little bit?
No, because it's different, and it's a different movie, and they told you that before they put it out.
I know, but like, my theory on that, man, though, is if they're going to do that, then don't even bother with the long time ago in a galaxy far, far away bit, because I've seen that 10 million times, and when I see that, I expect the fucking scroll afterwards. So, and I think if they were going to keep if the story scroll was not going to be in it,
good,
then don't positive. Fucking have that long time going to Galaxy Far, Far Away, but just go into the movie.
This is the guy that tells you to do something good for others and do something good for yourself. You know, that's change. That's different. Most people don't do that. Same thing with entertainment, man. It's just that something good for
you. Well, no, but they did something same and then they did something different.
Right,
they
but
did
it's not
something
what you
the
want.
Same and then they did something different. They couldn't decide on, you know.
Oh, yeah, a little bit different. You know, oh, my God.
It's the same, but it's different.
Fair enough.
All right.
Yeah, I can't argue that point. Good run, bro.
All right, whatever.
Good run.
Do something good for yourself. Do something good for somebody else.
Respect and I love you, boys, man. It's a pleasure, man.
I love you all.
View this.
I love you all, too. And I hope you enjoyed. What's that?
Do something? I don't know.
I already said it.
You what? Oh.
I already said it. My boy.
My boy.
Love you guys.